Ask anyone who's been to Assisi and they'll tell you how peaceful and uplifting it is up here. And the St. Francis Basilica is no exception. When you enter this two-story cathedral built to house the tomb of St. Francis, it feels so peaceful inside, especially with its cozy low ceilings that seem to embrace you and protect you when you're in there. You'll see them when we go inside for Mass. And there's a reason why Assisi and the Basilica are so peaceful. In 1228, the construction of the St. Francis Basilica began shrouded in controversy. It's well documented that the hill the Basilica was built on, at the specifications of St. Francis, was called Colla dell'Inferno, or Hell's Hill, because it was a site designated for executions. It was so bleak and barren that it aroused suspicion of anyone who even came close to it. It was probably so cursed that even its owner, Simone de Pucciarello, donated the land for the construction of the basilica. Whether it was due to the request of St. Francis or in hopes to consecrate this hell's hill, it's not known. Another unknown is why they called it Hell's Hill. After all, executing criminals in public areas was commonplace during those times, and it didn't make sense to me to have it called Hell's Hill based on that alone. So I wanted to find out if there's more to that story than we know. That's when the next legend comes in. If you recall the previous episode, there was a legend about hell holes existing in the area of Assisi, most of which are said to have been sealed off with religious buildings like the convent that I stayed at. This story continues to another hell hole, the second I've heard of in this area, and the third one is coming up. This one existed right underneath where the basilica now sits. Legend has it that it was a pagan ritual to execute or make human sacrifices in attempt to appease the god or gods to seal off the hellhole and prevent the devil and demons from coming through. It's quite possible that criminals are also executed there as well. Ironically though, in spite of these hellholes, Assisi always had a peaceful presence. And it's not impossible to imagine St. Francis wanting to extend that peace into Hell Hill by choosing to have his mortal remains buried there. Instantly, the name Hell's Hill became Paradise Hill, and it's been a paradise ever since. If legend is correct, having built a church over the Hell Hole has successfully kept out demons, because I, for one, haven't heard of any demon activities in Assisi lately. It's not known who the architects were that built the basilica, but what it is known is that Brother Elias was a major driving force in the design and the completion of the lower basilica that took only 2 years to finish, and it was a major accomplishment even by today's standards, if you consider its massive size and its position on a sloped hill. The plan of the basilica aroused many controversies even among the friars of the Franciscan order. Some wanted to follow the ideals of poverty and simplicity taught by the founder and build the church in a somber and austere architecture without decoration. Others, however, saw in the construction the evident proof of the magnitude of the Franciscan message. In order to achieve that, it is said the architects chosen to construct the basilica had traveled all over their known world to look for peaceful endeavors. And when they found them, they duplicated that knowledge when they worked on their individual projects. This tradition went on over the course of 500 years. In fact, Brother Elias himself had acquired his experience by building huge burial chambers in Syria. Because so many different architects cooperated in the design and creation of the basilica, there are different types of architectural styles revealed within the basilica, all inspired by the great religions of the world and their peaceful undertakings. Even artists like Giotto and Cimabue and others who decorated the basilica with frescoes were required to bring with them knowledge of peaceful places. All of the peace of the world went into this place. Although faded and worn away by time, the frescoes of the St. Francis Basilica are softer and kinder compared to other frescoes in other churches. Notice when you're in Assisi, you're at peace. You can't help it. St. Francis wanted to make it a peaceful place, and Assisi has definitely been the most peaceful place, even virtually avoided by the devastations of wars. During World War II, the Jewish refugees who reached Assisi, even when the city was under German occupation, were all saved. Priests, nuns, the town's mayor, and even the citizens of Assisi all worked together and chose to walk the paths of peace. Not convinced? On October 27, 1986, and January 2002, Pope John Paul II gathered in Assisi with the leaders of the great world to pray for peace. And every 2 years, right after the St. Francis Feast Day, there's a peace march that begins in the nearby town of Perugia and ends at the top of Assisi at Rocca Maggiore. And peace flags are seen hanging from many windows of the buildings in Assisi. Coincidence? I think not. And by the way, this is the year that we get to see the peace march. However, Mother Nature had her own agenda when, on September 26, 1997, on St. Francis' 816th birthday, Assisi was struck by an earthquake that caused 4 fatalities and significant damage to the basilica when part of a vault containing a fresco by Cimabue collapsed. The basilica was closed for 2 years for restoration. And as recently as 2 years ago, you could still see scaffolding clinging to the walls and cranes hovering above it, an ugly reminder. This year though, all traces of the earthquake restorations are gone. So let's go and enjoy the St. Francis Feast Day Mass inside the lower basilica. This celebratory mass always ends with everyone lining up to go below and pay their respects to St. Francis inside the crypt that contains his tomb. When I tell you there wasn't a single dry eye in the entire basilica during this mass, I'm not exaggerating. Grown macho mafioso men were moved to tears. This always seems to happen during the St. Francis Feast Day Mass. I don't know why. But it's one of the most moving, spiritually uplifting experiences of my life. If you're ever in Italy during the St. Francis Festival, I urge you to make a trip to Assisi and experience it for yourself and feel what St. Francis is all about. You don't even have to be Catholic. I'm not. This festival and mass transcends all religions and faiths. It brings all people together on a path of peace, just as St. Francis intended. So, let's go to Mass.